What's up, Burbank? Woo! Hello! My name is Jason Pfeiffer.
There it is. I'm the editor-in-chief of Entrepreneur Magazine. Welcome to Entrepreneur Live. We are so excited to have you here. We've got a great program scheduled, being totally open and learning from each other and knowing that it ain't easy. Being an entrepreneur ain't easy, but that's why we do it.
So we've got the hashtag going, EntLive. Let's make today trend.
Woo!
All right.
That's right. It doesn't matter what happens here today so long as we make a trend.
Let's make a trend.
We just hear no is the first step to yes. It's only a failure if you don't learn from it and you don't figure out, okay, that's what I'm not gonna do again and here's what I've learned and take it forward. We have a better story to tell and it'll be more successful in the long run.
If you have expertise in your field, your area, and you have over 10,000 hours in that area, your likelihood of success grows exponentially.
I had a real competitive advantage over anybody else coming into radio because I'd already had my 10,000 hours before I was a senior in high school.
You seek your passion. You don't have to show it, but if you love what you do, it's gonna show.
I've always had this kind of, looking back at it, this entrepreneurial spirit and little twitch inside me that I couldn't get away from.
Show them you're a person and you have struggles as well and you have difficulty, you have challenges. So they don't see it as like a perfectly packaged life and they feel like they can connect with you.
I believe that we are undervalued and I also think that Los Angeles represents a lifestyle that very few cities in the world provides.
Our mom showed us she was really the inspiration for Life is Good long before we launched the business.
I make this statement because we live in a society right now in a time where we have so much information. Like we have literally everything that we need to cure human suffering at this moment.
Take a look, have other people give you advice and say, is this really the right approach in the first place? Maneuver around it, but do it fast.
I think that it is so important that those that started with you, you find the way for them to stay with you, because they're part of it.
I shifted my perspective to enjoying the pursuit of that potential, of staying inspired. What do you guys use and what have you translated from your experience as an athlete to stay inspired every day?
I mean, a lot of my drive comes from my pure fear of failure. And so that's what drove me a lot of times in my career to train so insane and do things that other guys weren't willing to do.
Over time, I started to understand, not only understand the business, but you have to be okay with the small games and the small victories in order to really appreciate the big ones.
Elevator pitch, your time starts now.
I'm seeking $250,000 for 10% of my company.
I manufacture in the US, and I just need more support, more capital and revenue, and a good, honest investor.
We launched this summer in 2 test markets and have already sold over 200,000 shots and are looking to expand.
If you do it the same tomorrow, there's no growth. If you attain the same result tomorrow, there's no growth. So how do we get better? Every day, every hour. How do we find those resources? How do we find the energy, the knowledge to do that? At the end of the day, winners win and entrepreneurs make money. When we accept failure, we find success.